Mike Pence's latest campaign video is the best. It's one of my favorite campaign videos of all time because it really sheds light on the fact that politicians, especially politicians like Pence, don't know what it's like to just be a normal person. If you don't know what I mean, take a look at this.
Hey everybody, Mike Pence here. Remember $2 a gallon gas? I do. And then Joe Biden became president of the United States and launched his war on energy. Since that time, gasoline prices are up 60%. Electricity prices are up 25%. Joe Biden's war on energy is causing real hardship for working families, small businesses, and family farms. But we've got a plan to relieve all of that. We just unveiled the Pence Energy Plan that'll not only put our country back on a path to energy independence, but by 2040, we will reclaim America's role as the leading producer of energy in the world. Join us in the fight for American energy leadership by going to MikePence2024.com. We can lead the world once again to a more prosperous and a secure future for America with energy independence and American energy leadership.
She's totally filling the tank, you know. That was super believable. You know, not choosing, what do you call it? Which grade of gas? He didn't even select a grade of gas, but my favorite part.
Because he supports all grades of gas. That's all his energy plan, is they're all great.
They're all great. No, but my absolute favorite part is, put up the screenshot, put up the screen. In order to fill gas in that tank, Mr. Pence, you need to actually, you know, touch the trigger. You need to, like, pull it up.
Or pretend to pull it up, even. Like, literally just move your hand as if it's going around.
Exactly.
He didn't even do that.
No, he didn't do that.
Yeah.
But what this tells me, more than anything, is that Mike Pence thinks that if he just acts like a local news reporter in his campaign ads, he thinks he might win.
Yeah.
You know how local news reporters, they do the walk and talk for no reason? Or an event was held in a certain place, but the event is over. There's no one even at the event at that point. I'm standing here. And they like show the event venue. I don't need to see the event venue.
This is like, where the crash took place. There's no evidence of that. It could be any corner, but this is where it happened. Trust me.
But in order to equate it to what like Mike Pence did in that campaign ad, it would be the reporter reporting not from the event venue itself, but in front of a green screen.
Yeah. Look, it's not difficult to figure out why they did it this way. He had to deliver a whole bunch of scripted lines and he couldn't do it in one take. And the tank is already full after the first time. So they couldn't keep filling it up. I mean, the easy solution.
Mike Pence wouldn't know how to fill a tank if his life depended on it.
Yeah. I bet it's much more. It's much more likely than Donald Trump that he's actually gassed up his own truck or whatever. But like, just get a fake one that's not hooked up to anything, and then you can do that. Realize this isn't convincing. So just have him stand next to a gas like thing.
No one needs to see you. Like, even if he did it correctly, why do we need to see him putting gas in the truck? Like, what was the point of that? And it was so distracting that I don't even know what the campaign message was about. Like, what was the message?
Yeah, we're gonna drill more, basically. Which is, by the way, still more substantive than anything Donald Trump has said during this campaign. So I will give him credit on that.
I have the perfect campaign ads, the best campaign ads, like you wouldn't believe. Also, Mike Pence, not a good guy, very bad guy. But not as bad as Meatball Ron.
What I would like to see is on the debate stage, they should just have like eight gassing things. And just each candidate has to take a turn and fill up a car. And if you can't do that, you gotta get the hell off the stage. There's no way Donald Trump can do it. He will end up covering himself in gasoline and possibly being burned alive on the debate stage.
True, but to be fair, I'm actually jealous of people who never have to worry about filling their tanks because there is nothing more annoying than having to stop at a gas station.
That's true. I mean, the brief period where I had an electric car, it was nice to not go for a couple of years, but yeah.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.